I'm driving down the road and I'm praying to God. I say, God, I need some help. And the traffic gets real slow and it stops. And I come to a stop and I look over to my side there. And there's this billboard and it says, Shirdi Sai Baba meeting place, something. And this guy's a picture of Shirdi Sai Baba. And he's looking from out of the side of his eyes, kind of. And he's looking directly into my eyes, directly into my eyes. I'm just like, I'm just sitting there in traffic, getting darshan of Shirdi Sai Baba. Surf's up. The 99 days of summer are about ready to start. Memorial Day through Labor Day in the United States is 99 days. 99 days of summer. So we have our surfboard here. And we're ready to flow. Here comes summer. Yeah. And of course, it's not what we say, it's what we don't say. And what we don't say is everything. We don't have any answers at all. What do we need answers for? Like when summer arrives, do you need to, is summer an answer to something? Or is it summer? You sit there and you say, oh, okay, I've got summer, it's an answer. I got the answer, it's summer. Summer's the answer. No, it is summer. You don't need to worry about answering anything. So reality is not an answer to anything. So you don't need answers. Give up answers. I don't have any answers. Wow. Wow is greater than life and death. Okay, it's more powerful, it's greater than life and death. It's even greater than Arthur Rubinstein playing Frédéric Chopin's Concerto No. 2 in F minor with André Previn and London Symphony Orchestra. Wow's even greater than that. Okay, it's the greatest thing there is in this world is wow. Because it's basically saying everything and nothing. It's putting you into this no answer mode. And so we don't have any spiritual teaching here. We don't have any answers at all. Except getting used to no answers. Getting used to it. Familiarity is absolutely key. There's no way that anyone ever will be liberated from hell, the mental hell of seeking for answers, of trying to become instead of being, without going through this process of familiarity, getting refamiliarizing themselves with nothing at all, no answers at all. So we pivot our mind into emptiness, meaning no answers. Just emptiness is a good word. And we get familiar with this by paying attention. Familiarity wins. Familiarity is decisive. Wow is the greatest thing there is. It says everything, doesn't it? So we don't want these times to go down unstamped by the Dharma Kings. We want the Dharma Kings to put their stamp upon these times. And so let us be the ink that they use to put their stamp on these times. These times must be stamped by the Dharma Kings. Absolutely. Because we've never had times like this, actually. Not quite like this. No. It is a crisis, this absolute crisis, a creature crisis, a creature crisis. Went into a house yesterday, visiting with some people, the dog showed up, and from that point on, all talk was centered on the dog. A couple days ago, working late, come across a friend of mine. We spent like 15 minutes talking about Jesus. It was the day before was Ascension Day. And he said, I didn't know that. Nobody said anything about it. Yeah, nobody says anything about Ascension Day. But they'll talk about dogs endlessly. Creatureness. See, the to try become abnormal, we end up believing we're creatures. We're trying to become abnormal. Becoming is abnormal. We're trying to become anything at all. Just becoming. You know, in other words, process, time, space, process, form. Moments interlinked with other moments going towards some goal, some answer. That's called creatureness. And so those who are trying to become like hanging out with creatures. And they themselves are acting like creatures. And it's getting so strong now that if you're not already in full desperation shock mode, then I don't know what can help. Who wants to be a creature? But wow is greater than any creature. Wow is greater than any creature. So, what you do is you induce revelation by being willing to wow whatever arises, being committed to no action at all, being committed to doing nothing at all, no creatureness at all, no explanation, no description. Wow is saying everything. It's basically everything is being said. That's being. Being is everything. Being is always forever. It's always everything. God is all value, everywhere, always. So wow just says it all. Everything is being said. So get used to everything being said. No answer. Everything is always being said. They're all answers, everywhere, always. There's just being. There's just being, not being this or that, just being. So no teacher, no teaching, no student. No teaching, no teacher, no student. So just practicing getting familiar with that and wowing the success that arrives. So the surf is definitely up. Actually, in summer, it's way down. But that's okay. Because the idea is, maybe we'll actually get out in the water and do a little surfing. But surf's up for us in the 99 days of summer. Because what are we? We are the ones who realize, hey, we're not creatures. We're not creatures. We don't need any answers. What do we have to do? Explain answers to some creature? There's no creatures. That's a misperception. So we don't. There's no need for any answers. Nothing has to be answered. So, you have a dessert, like you listen to some great classical music, and it's just, I listened to it, I said, oh, that's nice. I was in a car driving, and the classical music station was on someone else's car, and I ordinarily just hit it right off, you know, not interested. Just noise. Just noise. It's just a dog barking. And but this time I didn't. I said, hey, wait. I said, that's not bad. That's okay. And I listened more and more, and I said, yeah, you know what? That's actually it's actually pretty good. I want to find out who it is. And it turns out it's Chopin, and one of his greatest. And but it's just like eating some ice cream, which I did a few days ago for the first time in years. And I was like, blah. You know, afterwards, I feel kind of lousy in the mouth, you know. And it's just ice cream. It's just ice cream. Music is just ice cream. Nothing to waste your time on at all. Dim lights, thick smoke, and loud music is just about the only thing you'll understand. Yeah, it's all dim light, thick smoke, and loud music. That's all the world is, actually. So we practice no answers, no answers. There are no answers here. There are no answers here at all. Just feel, how does it feel to have no answers? Now, you're probably not going to hear this from anybody. Hardly anyone. But you're hearing it here. Who's going to say, I have no answers? Yeah, this is the most difficult thing to say in the world. I have no answers whatsoever. Someone who believes there's a creature is constantly trying to find answers, right? Oh, yeah, I got some answers. Here, we don't have any answers. So really, the highest practice is to practice getting used to hearing it. No, I have no answers. Now, even higher is Ram Maharshi, just silence. How often do we get that, and how often do we get to see Ram Maharshi? You know, maybe we'll see him. I pray we do. But in the meantime, we do the best that we can. All these big warplanes flying overhead. B-52s, four-prop warplanes from World War II. There's another one flying overhead right now. They're just all over the place right now. There's a big air show in the Bay Area, Memorial Day weekend. Now, if we don't need answers, and we can accept, I don't have any answers. I'm okay with that. I'm okay that I don't have any answers. Then what do we need in the world for? Who cares what happens to this world? The world doesn't have any answers. And if it did, it doesn't matter. I don't need any. I don't have any. Truth doesn't need any answers. For what? What does it need to answer to? It's experience. When we're in summertime, We just enjoy it. It's not an answer to anything. Happiness, peace, love, bliss, joy is inherent. It's not caused. It's what we are. We are it. We are it. We're not an answer to something. We're it. Uncaused, we're uncaused. What we are is uncaused. Reality is uncaused, totally uncaused. It's not causal, it's intrinsic. It's not causal, it's intrinsic. So there aren't any answers. There's nothing causing what we are. No thing causing what we are. There's just intrinsicness. God is. Anything you say is too vague, right? It's the allness. It's intrinsic. It's not caused. It's the basis. It's the ground. It's the basis. The isness, the being, is not caused by anything at all. And everything is eternally uncaused, actually. All is eternally uncaused. There's no causative experiencing at all. So we made it through to 99 days of summer. We made it through the 99 days of spring. Okay, so now 99 days of summer. I don't know how it'll go. People are determined to go to their graves ignorant, but I'm determined to not be at fault in that. If they want to, then they will. But I have to speak up. I already have spoken up and said so much, so I cannot be held at fault. They just, if they ignore it, that they're at fault for that. But certainly, we want to make sure that everyone does not go to their grave ignorant. And that we make a turnaround and stop being trying to be totally ignorant, trying to be a creature. Ignorance may seem like a fun game to play, but the fun doesn't last very long. It's like a game we're playing. How ignorant can we be? And music doesn't do anything to remove the ignorance at all. It doesn't do anything. It's just a flea on a dog is all it really is. I'm listening to Jesus, A Course in Miracles, haranguing, you know, exhorting, haranguing. It's like, oh my God, you have so many words. But, you know, I'm glad he's doing it. Words are inherently vague, so they're like poisonous, really. You have to be very careful. But his spirit comes through anyway. Sometimes it's better to just not say much of anything, actually. Just gather your resolve and pivot your mind into emptiness. Gather your resolve and pivot your mind into emptiness. Don't pivot. Don't stop seeking for answers. Forget about answers. No one has any answers. There are no answers. There are no answers. Just say that. There are no answers. Nobody has any answers. There are no answers at all. Nothing's ever been born. There is no mother because nothing's ever been born. There's no father because nothing's ever been born. No causation, no answers. Just be shocked by it. That's the real shakti, is just hearing the truth and say, oh my gosh, I need answers. Well, that's not an answer, right? The answer is there are no answers. And more importantly, don't try to make an answer out of no answers. Most importantly, because that's where we have fallen. Call it whatever you want. What happens is when you don't approach it from the wow standpoint, from non-action, no conclusions, one way or the other, do not put it in. When we don't approach it that way, what happens is we make an answer out of no answers, no answer. And that's what leads to trouble, 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 trouble. And ultimately, we stall out. This is what's happened to these generations that are here in this world right now. You can say that they've stalled out. They've stalled out because they tried to make an answer out of no answer. They thought, oh, I got it. Now I got it. It's no answer. But then they tried to make that the answer. Okay, that's the mistake we've all made. Mistake we've all made. And we just need to recognize it. That's all. We're mature enough now to realize this is the mistake we've really made. In a way of spirit trying to be liberated from expectation as expectations. Even no answer is not an answer. Okay, even no answer is not an answer. Very simple. It's easy if you just sit quietly. And don't try to do anything, plan anything, take action in any way. Now, I've been practicing the wow during the 99 days of spring, constantly had to. So intense. So intense. The experiencing I've been having is so intense. It's been everything I can do just to survive it. So I had to, you know, use the wow all the time. It's been a heavy, heavy time. Very difficult. I had to get rid of some really heavy stones today. Slabs. And I wasn't sure I'd be able to do it. I had to push them off. I was supposed to... one of them was just so huge and so heavy. You know, you try to push, you can't budge it. I said, how am I going to do this? So I was kind of worried, but I did it. I was able to pivot it and slide it, and I was able to get rid of all these super heavy stones, slabs. And after I did that, I was elated. I said, I just felt like a new, you know, like I'd been liberated somehow. And my whole attitude just totally shifted. I thought I needed help. I would need to ask help from someone. I said, no, you know what, let me try. I was able to do it. So I did it by pivoting the stone, pivoting it. Instead of just trying to push it straight, I got an edge, a corner, and I pivoted the corner. And then I got out a corner, I pivoted that, and I sort of walked it that way. So pivoting the mind is the key term we want to talk about. Pivot the mind, gather your resolve, and pivot the mind. You may think it's too difficult to turn away from ignorance. But if you pivot the mind, you can do it. You can do it. I had a dream, I believe, either last night or the night before, where I did just that. I suddenly was looking into this chaotic worldly situation. I said, I don't want to get into that. And it was pulling me back, calling me back. I said, no. And I was able to pivot my mind 180 degrees. And then I looked out upon this very peaceful, serene life and world. Very peaceful, serene world. I was quite surprised. I said, oh my gosh, I did it. I didn't know if I could do it. So it was just like that rock. My friend said, you might have trouble getting it out. And someone said, well, you probably might be able to do it. I might have to smash it with a sledgehammer. So I had a sledgehammer there to smash it if I needed to. I said, no, let me just try and do it. And was able to do it. You know, resolve, strength, resolve, strength, resolve. pivot the mind into emptiness. What does emptiness mean? No answer. No answer, no answer. I mean, that's going to feel so wonderful to let go of answers, trying to find answers, believing in answers. There are no answers. Don't believe in answers. Relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go. Especially all thoughts of answers. And we can do it. We can do it. We can pivot into emptiness. Now we can stay there for a while, and if we crave pursuing creatureness again, then we could always do that if we want to. But for now, gather resolve, pivot your mind into emptiness. No teacher, no teaching, no student. Just accept that. It's only the pretension of becoming that is seeking answers, is seeking teachers and teaching. And we say, well, I can't stop seeking because I haven't found the answer. Stop seeking answers. That's what we need to stop. There are no answers. We have no answers. We don't need any answers. Nothing is causing us. Nothing is causing being. Being is God. There's nothing causing God. All is God. There's no causation causing God. So there's no answers to be found of like what's causing God, what's causing joy, what's causing it. God is it. There's only God. So now we're in a new chapter, 99 Days of Summer. It's a new chapter. So we're just turning the page and looking at the new chapter here. And don't make no answer the answer. That's the fatal mistake. So it may seem easy. You say, oh yeah, I got it. No answer. I've got that. That's not it. It's wowing. No answer. Wow. So real meditation is wowing no answer, just wowing it, not saying you have it. Wow is saying, is it saying, is saying everything. So just get used to believing that you're saying everything. You're saying everything. Silence is not emptiness. Silence is saying everything. Just like light contains all colors of the spectrum. So it's resolve. It don't gather answers. Gather your resolve to pivot into no answer. And maybe you'll surprise yourself. I was surprised in that dream. I said, "Wow." And I was scared. I thought, "Oh, there's this traffic." I was like a car. I was like making a U-turn in the car, and I thought, "Oh, I'm gonna get hit. I'm gonna get hit. I'm gonna get hit." But nothing hit me. Huh, I didn't know I could do that. So we don't realize we can do this. We just pivot our mind. Don't change the mind, just pivot it. So the mind now is, the tension is on emptiness, no answer. And it's not even on no answer. It's just wow. So just be empty, even empty of emptiness. And actually, that's total fullness, it's wowness. The final step is to even let go of emptiness. And then we realize it's there's nothing but complete fullness. There's only complete fullness, always. So what could possibly need an answer? Answers, it means that there's a lack somewhere, right? There's no lack anywhere. Here comes summer. Woo. Da 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 dum. Here comes summer. Yeah. So we welcome the 99 days of summer. Don't be surprised if you just pivot your attention. Suddenly you just pivot. You just, I don't know where it came from. You know, it was just, I just, well, I realized I don't want to continue on with the madness, right? I said, no, I've had enough. So I have to turn away from it. And it just felt this resolve. I said, okay, I'm just going to do it. I said, I'm gonna put it all on the line right now. That's how I felt. I'm gonna put it all on the line right now. And then this resolve arose, and I was able to do it in the dream. But dreams usually, like that, they presage what's going to happen. A foreshadowing. It means it's my mind, you know, has decided to do it and has done it. Now, how that plays out, I don't know, and I'm not really worried about it one way or the other. Here comes summer. Woo, 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 woo. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Amazing. The summer of silence, which is saying everything, always. Now, most may go to their grave in total ignorance. But don't you be that one. And it's very simple to not be that one. You just don't try to make no answer the answer. And really make your resolve around that so strong it's you know, more important than life and death to you. Gather your resolve and say, wow, even no answer is not the answer. Even emptiness is not the emptiness. It's really everything. All answers are always present. Everything is always present. There can never be any actual neediness at all. And so, we don't want anyone to go to their grave ignorant. That's taking a joke too far. It's taking the joke too far. This is all just a joke, but there's, you know, taking it too far is going to your grave in ignorance. The joke falls flat at that point. So, you know, we've had our little joke, and now it's time to drop the ignorance. And listening to Chopin is not dropping the ignorance. Even if Arthur Rubinstein is playing it, it's not dropping the ignorance at all. It's just trying to hold on to the joke. A little longer. Wait a little longer, please, Jesus. There are so many still sunk in sin. Ooh. Well, we better not wait too long for Jesus. Because before you know it, the joke's on us. And you might be saying, well, I don't think I can make it. That's because we haven't realized that the mistake we've made is trying to make no answer the answer. If we just can hear this, changes everything, changes the whole, pivots your mind, pivots your mind. Your mind pivots and says, ah. So let the sun shine down on my old summer home. Yeah, summertime is the time to pivot the mind into emptiness. That's what it's for. This is what it's for right now. So we're right on track. Absolutely 100% right on track here. As always. Just like practicing something, whatever it is you practice. Just keep hearing it over and over. It's amazing how we'll practice all sorts of stuff, right? Like trying to hit a golf ball. It will, well, thousands and thousands and thousands of swings. We'll keep working year after year. And yet we don't practice hearing the truth, you know, absorbing it, feeling it, accepting it, getting familiar with it. We should do it over and over and over and over and over, just like trying to groove your golf swing or play the piano nicely or dance or knit or sing or do any hobby that, you know, we need to practice at it. We need to practice, 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 practice. No answer. And wow, the no answer, so we don't turn it into an answer. Very simple, right? No answer. Wow. Now, if we're thinking, well, maybe that hurts some teacher's feelings, well, too bad for them, right? I don't care who the teacher is, even Jesus. I say, Jesus, there's no answer, okay? Wow. Now, I get up to take communion. I don't take communion. So I get up to take a blessing. Everyone's getting communion. And the one giving communion saw that I had my arms crossed. Like, oh, and they looked right at me and said, Jesus loves you. And the homily was all about, there was this lovely Irish priest who's giving such a beautiful homily, selling the, you know, the body and the flesh, the creatureness. Jesus died on the cross to show you that creatureness is nothing. It's nothing. Profiteth nothing. The body, creatureness, profiteth nothing. So he said, nothing to me at all. It's not what I am. It's not what you are. Anyway, he was saying that Jesus said, look, you know, if you love me, keep my commandments. Do what I told you to do. Follow my teachings. That's what I want of you. So it's really nice to just have someone say to me, Jesus loves you, meaning maybe I followed Jesus' commandments. I followed what he wants. No answer. Maybe Jesus does love me. Possible. I don't know. I mean, he loves everywhere. I mean, God is love. Perfect inclusivity. We can't even use words to describe it. But in terms of, is somebody actually, you know, practicing properly and getting familiar with truth? And, you know, that's something to be happy about, something to love. So we may think that we're doomed. You know, people in the U.S. may be thinking they're doomed, they're doomed. You know, the world may be thinking we're doomed. Here it's just the opposite. We've already raised our game above the world here as we go into this summer, which is, from a worldly standpoint, it's beyond intense. From our standpoint, we've already overcome that. We already have the practice. We raised our game practicing no answer. Wow. Now, is Sai Shirdi Baba giving me any answer? He was just looking at me, just most intensely like this. No, I didn't feel like there's some answer or anything. It was just a darshan. Maybe he was giving me no answer. You know, giving this fullness, totality. That was really quite unexpected, to say the least. And it's the only sign with a guru, billboard with a guru in the Bay Area or anywhere in California that I could determine. And I just happened to, the car just happened, the vehicle just happened to stop on the expressway right there in perfect alignment with this billboard. Right at the moment, the crucial moment, I really had to decide, you know, what to do. And how can you even, you know, fathom such synchronicity? He wasn't giving any teaching out or any answers out. He was just silent. He's saying, I have all answers. And so do you. And so does everyone. I have everything. But it's not an answer. Because since we don't have any questions, what do we need answers for? Only the pretense of becoming has some question, like what will we become, right? That's a question, isn't it? But there's no becoming at all actually taking place. And we are intrinsically God, uncaused. Everything is uncaused. All is uncaused. Ceaselessly uncaused. Eternally uncaused. Always and forever uncaused. Beautiful evening. Finally. Yeah. It's trying to trend that way. So to be in this world and profess no answers in a super positive manner as the ultimate help for the world, which it is, well, it's second only to the Dharma Kings. Who radiate fullness, say they're constantly saying everything. But second only to that is professing no answer as compassion, as help, as true compassion, true help, the highest compassion, the highest help, no answer from the standpoint of professing, understanding that Dharma kings have an even higher capacity to just radiate everything. They're saying everything. They're expressing everything. Now, we're placing ourselves in a favorable position, more favorable than anything the world can, you know, throw at us in terms of trying to bring us down. We're so in such a favorable position, we can't be dragged down at this point. There's no within, there's no without, there's only everything. There's only the allness. And don't make no answer an answer. If we just concentrate on this, we will succeed. If we don't concentrate on this, then we won't succeed. I experience the inner dynamic that's going on right now. It's amazing, but it's true. I saw something, experienced something so sublime and beautiful, and suddenly this reaction arose in me and said, "That's atrocious! What an atrocity!" And this real harpy kind of voice, you know, very snappy, dismissing kind of voice. "That's an atrocity." I said, "What?" And I stayed with it. And then again, that voice said, "That's absurd. That's absurd." In other words, this super beauty, you know, is absurd. They're calling it an atrocity. It's absurd. This is the underlying reaction that our expectations and familiarity have, because when it sees something really beyond what it expects, it gets frightened, gets angry, and starts shrieking, "Oh, what an atrocity!" But don't, you know, hearing that was great. Say, okay, that's how it feels. So you must understand within you, there's that which insists that reality, peace, love, bliss is an atrocity and an absurdity. We call it the ego, but it's really just fear based on our expectations, familiarity. So do not react angrily or argumentatively. Just notice it. Say, "Huh. Wow." It really is there. And so, the more we can just get familiar with no answer, gradually that those reactions subside. They gradually subside. You cannot force them to go away. You cannot force them to subside. Just repetitively getting used to, over and over again, no answer. And as we get used to that and familiar with it and expecting it, then it just, those reactions will not arise. That's all. So do not be dismayed if you get these negative reactions. That just means it's a very positive to be aware of this. Very positive. It just means, okay, it means I'm really making great progress here, such that my expectations are being surpassed to such an extent. I'm getting quite jittery. So don't panic when that happens. You may even have, you know, real harsh reactions, wanting to dismiss. Dismiss the success that you're having. Just notice that. Just notice it. Don't react. Just say, wow. Wow. Saying everything. Wow. Every last thing could be said. I'm saying it. Everything in the moment right now. Wow. It's not some alter ego that's saying that. It's your own reactions. It's our own reactions based on fear. Like, oh my gosh, this is really surpassing what I expect. This is beyond my expectations. And I don't know where this is going to lead me. And what am I going to do? And how am I going to, you know, what should I expect? I don't know. This is scary. So it's scary. But the more we sit here quietly like this, the more those reactions die down. Friend of mine was drilling a hole through this rock, and it was going real slow, and I said, well, that's really hard rock, isn't it? He says, yeah, it is. You just got to go slow. It takes a while. And someone else had a hose on it of water to dissipate the heat, so it wouldn't soften the metal and ruin the teeth on the metal core bit. Want to keep the metal cold. Keeps its strength that way. Or cool. So He said, it's just going to take a while. That's all. Just stick with it. So it's like we're drilling through this really hard rock. Really, really dense, hard rock. The belief in answers, the belief in becoming, belief in all these beliefs. And just stay patient. Keep the wow on it. Keeps everything cool. But we may not seem to be doing anything here, but we're drilling through that rock, actually. We're making progress, drilling through it. So practicing this way is the fastest way to drill through the rock. So we will see who wants to drop the ignorance and who wants to continue to try and be a creature. Continue the game of becoming, the pretense of becoming, which is always seeking all sorts of answers, like how do I become something? Of course we can't. We're everything. We're always everything. We can never become something. Everything is eternally liberated already. So we're sitting here quietly. The body's not playing any role at all, really, is it? We don't need the body to try and do something, find an answer. No answers. And we might say, well, what do we need a body and a world for? Exactly. We don't. We already have everything. We only have everything. We only have everything. We only have the perfectly uncreated, already liberated everything. So how can we say we have a world when we actually have everything? We don't have anything, we have everything. We are everything. We are everything. Die in ignorance, right? Dying is ignorance. But that's not an answer. And no answer is not an answer either. Emptiness is not emptiness. There's only everythingness. Intrinsically so. Uncaused everythingness. Uncaused everythingness. Allness. Uncaused allness. Uncaused allness. Only uncaused allness. So we're getting a running start here on the 99 days of summer, and leave it open, you know, to what's going to take place. I don't know. I don't even know what's going to happen, you know, a minute from now. Grace of God is at work. So rest in no answers. So we're not worried about the news. Oh, what do I do? Oh, I've got to figure an answer for this. You know, I've got to calm myself down. I'm seeking for answers. I'm not sure I can find. No, we have no. We have no answers here. That's what we have. We have everything. Always have everything. So how can we be threatened? So don't look at no answers as a defeatist negative position. It's the highest positive, super positive position. I don't have any answers at all. Wow. So keep in mind, it's not a position. This is a familiarity situation where we're getting familiar with this. So we must, instead of trying to say nothing, say wow, say everything. Say everything, say wow. Instead of trying to force silence upon yourself, say wow. Again, silence is not absence, it's everythingness. Where nothing is being highlighted or emphasized, because the allness is being emphasized. Silence emphasizes the allness. Ramaharshi's silence, he says, is actually, I'm saying everything. It's the greatest eloquence there is. It's not an absence. It's a complete fullness. It's a complete fullness. So emptiness is empty of any emphasis. It's perfect equal fullness, everything. Empty of emphasis. So in gathering your resolve to pivot your mind into emptiness, which is really the fullness of no emphasis, be serious. Be earnest. Saradatta Maharaj always said the whole key to it all is earnestness. So we try to strike that tone. We're very earnest here. We're not somber, we're positively earnest. We can laugh and adds little flourishes, but our mood is one of earnestness. And the Sagarada Maharaj says there's nothing works better than that. He said that's the key, the absolute key, is you have to have this earnestness. Must have this earnestness. And don't worry, though, what Maharaj says about answers, this or that. There are no answers. So give up the seeking, the whole seeking mechanism, give it up. There are no answers. Wow. I've given up seeking because there are no answers. Wow. Like that. And giving up seeking answers also means you're giving up trying to motivate others to find answers for you, right? Just accept, I will never find any answers at all. I will never have any answers at all. And I accept that. I'm not going to try and influence anyone to seek answers for me, right? I'm not going to try and manipulate or influence anyone to find some emphasis for me, some answer emphasis. There are no answers here. No answers here at all. And especially no answer. No answer is not the answer. And we don't have to do great at this. We're just working on familiarity, right? Working on our expectations. So we're not judging, well, how good did I get the answer? No, we're just working on getting used to it. I get in the pool and just float around and swim a little bit and, you know, just dog paddle if you want to a little bit. And, you know, just get in the pool. You don't have to be some, you know, great swimmer. The pool's not very deep anyway. Just float in the pool. be aimless, aimless, absolutely aimless. Without making aimlessness your aim. And just observe your mind, is it? My mind's doing fine, but I know, not, it doesn't always do fine. I mean, you have ups and downs. Right now it's doing great, but there are times, times, a lot of the time it's and today was freaking out until I pushed those stones. Pushed those stones away. And as soon as I finished that, suddenly, like this burden just lifted off of me. It was amazing. I just said, oh my, I'm okay. I'm going to be okay. I thought I might be burdened with these stones. I couldn't get rid of them. But I had the strength and resolve to do it. And pivoted them. And it worked. What a relief. What a relief that was. So this huge relief just happened. And then everything just brightened up. So don't give up. Don't think, oh, I'm, something will come about where you'll gather your resolve. And that makes all the difference. Suddenly, somehow, you'll just gather your resolve and say, for me it was, I believe I have enough strength. I'm really in great shape. I've been working out, for more than a year and a half, and I just feel like I feel I have the strength to do it. I have confidence, and so somehow that helped produce resolve that I'm going to tackle this. I'm going to tackle this, and I believe I can do it. Now I'm not that strong, but I know I've put in a lot of work, and I'm not terribly weak either. So I just, so you don't have to be super, super, super. You just have to, if you put in the time and the effort and the practice, you're going to feel, I could probably do this. And that somehow galvanizes resolve. If you haven't done it, you're going to worry about it, say, I need someone else to do it for me, or I need some help. But if you really have put in the work, you're going to have this inner confidence saying, I bet you that work is going to pay off for me now. And I said, let me see what my strength can do here. And I said, oh, okay, I can move it. That's not too difficult. I'm able to do that. Interesting. So practice pays off. Practice pays off. At the crucial moment where you need to get those stones rolled away, you're going to have the confidence and say, I believe I really apply myself to this. I'm going to succeed. I will succeed at this. Or it's at least worth a try. At least worth a try. You see, we don't know unless we try. And so confidence brings this resolve, said, I'm going to try. I'm going to try to do this. Maybe I can do it. Maybe. Yeah. It's worth a try. It's worth a try. So right now, it's worth a try. See if you can feel like, this summer, 99 days of summer, it's worth a try. And turn the chapter. What's past, what's gone is gone, what's past is past. It was just, we were working out, we were gaining resolve, gaining strength, ups and downs and all that. I've been through just exactly that, ups and downs. Needed to gather resolve. And now we'll say, let's use the resolve and see what we can do. Let's use the resolve we have and see if we can roll the stone away. And get the weight. get that weighting off our shoulders so we don't have to wait anymore for what can't really be defined, because it's everything, allness. We'll just call it wowness. Just call it wowness. We don't even have to call it God. We can call it wowness. That's a nice way to put it, isn't it? And I So gather our resolve, and we can try to, stop waiting for wowness. Stop waiting for wowness. Stop trying to find the answers. Okay, now I got it. Now I can. Now there's nothing to get. No answer to get. There's no answer to get. There's only the wowness. That's it. The uncaused wowness. No answer to get. Only the uncaused wowness. That's it. Well, welcome back, everyone. We'll see if there's anyone pays attention. Some will, for sure. It's the wild, wild west out there in the world right now. There's no doubt about it. Those who have, gone into creatureness, believing they're creatures, are going to suffer a lot. There's no doubt about that. Suffer the torment of believing you're a creature. Because creatureness cannot understand, no answer, cannot accept it. That's completely contrary to the whole premise of creatureness. So they will continue to flail and flounder, no doubt about it. And yet, we won't flail and flounder. No doubt about that. Stay away from the ice cream, too. Just because it's summer doesn't mean, I can eat anything I want to. I don't know where we got this idea. I guess it's like summer starts, like, oh, yeah, I can eat sweets and ice cream and all this. It's okay. I don't know where I got that. it seems difficult to keep. It's kind of like summer's like vacation. You take a vacation from your diet, too, and your exercise and stuff. No, I say, no. Keep the diet going. Keep the exercise. I went out and got two bundles of kale yesterday. And I'm back on the kale smoothies. I stopped for a while. Back on the kale smoothies. Vitamin water and kale smoothies. Trying to, drop a few pounds. And working out. And trying to, saying, hey, I got to keep it going during the summer. It's not a vacation from good habits. Not at all. But summers, I always felt, it's what a relief to get out of school, right? To stop, not have to seek for answers, in school. Just, forget it. I forgot all about school in summertime. And just experience. Just be. I always wanted summer to go on forever, the endless summer. So I wouldn't have to go back to schooling and class and have to focus on answers. What an abomination that is. That's creature-based belief. That we need to educate. We're creatures that need to be educated. We're not creatures. We don't need to be educated. We're spirit. We're free. We are the wowness. We are the wowness. And why? There's only the wowness. There's only the wowness. So how could we not be the wowness? There's only the wowness. And that wowness is right now. In a dream, at what point in a dream is the dream not right now? At what point in a dream is the dream stop being right now? At what point in a dream is the dream become distant from right now? From right here, right here. At what point in a dream does the dream become distant from right here? At what point in a dream does a dream... is a dream not right now? So if we're dreaming like a dream of a million years ago, is that dreaming of a million years ago, isn't that taking place right now? Is it or is it not taking place right now? So when is a dream not taking place right now? When is dreaming somehow not be dreaming right now? If we're dreaming of a billion, you know, light years away, some far, far place away, well, where is that dream? How does that, at what point does that dream not be taking place right here? Right here, right now? Don't answer that. Just consider it. What part of a dream is not right now? What part of a dream is not a dream right now? What part of a dream is not right now? If I'm dreaming of yesterday, what part of dreaming about yesterday is not dreaming right now? No conclusions. Don't draw any conclusions. Just wow. All is the wowness. All is the wowness. How could there be any conclusions to draw? All is the wowness. Okay. Very great. That's enough for this one.